Oh, Danny Axel just went live. Oh, hey, we just went live.
Did we just go live?
We're doing
it. Oh, shit, I didn't update the fucking thing. I'll do it in real time.
Cool.
It still says we're playing. Oh, no. Good job, Dan.
Danny Axel just went live. Let's see what we're playing right now.
It's going to say we're playing No Mercy.
Hey. Oh, yeah.
I knew there was a step. I forgot.
Shout out to all the Steves in the world. Shout out to all the Steves who mislead gamers and put other games that they're playing to trick them into to watching it.
Yeah, right.
Whatever works. Whatever works.
That's really funny. I hope I can change it while we're on. I would hate to have to disconnect already.
Well, it's cool. I'm loading the stream on my phone. We'll see.
Wow, what an epic way to start, like, the game. We're literally playing the game right now. I was telling Sean, this is probably, to completion, the game I have played the most times in my life. And if you follow Steve, then you know you've seen me do some of it before. Link to the Past is my shit.
Yeah. I forget how old I was when I started playing this game. Maybe like 5 or 6 years old.
The most times. Oh, God. Oh, I'm hearing myself. Hold up. My life. Shut up. Shut up, Dan. Shut up.
Oh,
and
wow.
If you follow Steve, then you know.
Yes.
Oh,
it's cool.
Shut up.
You can't see that on the stream.
Oh, no.
Oh, there's ants in our headphones. You can't hear it. You're just going to hear a scream. I'm gonna play that back, actually.
Oh, God. Shut up, Dan.
Okay, so I lied. You can't hear that one giant ad. Like,
great, great, perfect. Oh no, off to a blazing start.
Should we just redo this, man?
No, no. This is how it starts.
Like we could just like, hey, I'm grump. I'm not so grump. It over. You know what I mean?
No, no. How do I? All right.
You're struggling right now.
Is it?
Oh yeah, dude, The Legend.
Oh God, why? I wasn't ready.
There you go. First one.
Of course, it's the first one because it's the best. Okay, controversial statement. My ass. Truth. Best Zelda game ever. Link to the Past.
Yeah, I would say, gameplay, control wise, best Zelda game.
It's the one they're all based on.
Yeah. I would say it's the second most influential next to Ocarina.
I don't think so. I don't think that Ocarina is that influential. The lasting legacy of Ocarina of Time is Z targeting, and that's huge. It's huge.
It's not just that though. It's not just that. It's a
really,
story.
No, it really is. The story. What? The story. Oh, you mean going between two different realms? One that's lighter and one that's darker? Oh yeah, that sounds new. What up, Doopy? Yo, Doopy in the house. I wasn't looking at the screen. That's great.
That's cool. Let us embrace the very engaging story of Link to the Past.
Damn right. Link to the Past, origin story of the Master Sword. What?
The Wizard Arcanine.
Get it.
My favorite part is...
Oh, excuse me. Skyward Sword is the origin story.
The one thing that I didn't know about this game... What about when you beat the dungeons in the Dark World and there's always that cutscene when you save the princess and she's like, long ago in the wizard's cavern! Like, oh, man. That's the part where I'm going to bust the most boss. I'll focus on the good because I love this game. I used to play this a lot in, like, first grade.
Mm.
For sure.
Me too.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's interesting in that way. It's like we probably had a very similar childhood experience. It's just for me, it was when it came out.
You know? Nice. And dude, the lag is not bad, man.
Is there lag? There shouldn't be any.
No, not really.
Okay.
Doesn't feel like it.
Yeah, we've had a level up behind the scenes lately. I figured out my computer's getting up in the tooth, and I figured out how to get it to run nicer when we stream, so... You're going to see, actually, I think that means our gameplay is going to go up, and now our legacy of being bad at everything is going to be
tarnished. Oh, man, that's super. Catch the Super Mario World stream. We actually didn't do Star Road yet, either, in that game.
I know, now I feel like now we could do it.
Yeah, I mean, now we could attempt to do
it. Yo, we beat that whole fucking game with lag on the controller, man. That's deserving of some respect, I think. I want to get drunk during this stream, I just realized.
Jeez, man. I mean, yeah, teach us
how. I might drink my remaining Budweisers. They're awful. I hate Budweiser. I mean, yo, props to other Danny though for hooking me up with free beer. Like, I never want to be that guy.
But no, that's cool.
It's just not a good beer.
Yeah, it fucks my insides up, and
yeah, and I don't like that.
I'm on an official like at least 2 week hiatus from drinking.
Nice, you pushed it.
I should have mentioned on the stream. I went on like a day and a half drinking bender, and I met the drummer of the band 9 Days, Vince. He's like a really cool dude.
We're already talking about it.
That's yeah, great. It was just so, actually probably like a big life event. I mean, I'm gonna try to stay in touch with him.
So can I get that controller for like 1 second?
Sure.
Well, wait, we'll kill these guys. You haven't gotten hit yet, right?
No.
All right, don't get hit and kill these guys, and then give me that controller.
Okay. Right. Here we go. All
right, cool.
MLG Pro. All
right, cool. We cool. Now, if I just don't fuck this up, then we're gonna be real cool.
You gonna beat the game right now?
If I do fuck this up, then we're not gonna be that cool.
What? What are you doing?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What are you doing right now?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Why did you save and quit?
I don't know what you're talking about.
That's not what you do.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man. Why am I doing this? This is stupid.
What are you doing?
This is stupid. I don't know why I'm doing this right now. And I might fuck it up because I'm like, I might be forgetting a crucial detail, but if I don't...
I'd be really impressed if you pull this off.
If I don't fuck it up, then yeah, we're going to have a laugh right now. If I get hit, it's over, though. Oh, shit. I feel the pressure in the Twitch community.
You got to do a lot of spin doctors.
Oh, I don't want to do that. Yeah, I got a story about that guy being an asshole too.
Oh, really? Yeah, that sucks. Like, that's a really nice song. That's a really nice melody.
Yeah,
I should say.
I really like that album. Yeah, a buddy of mine was playing a show opening for them, and he was finishing up his set. You know, they were packing up their gear, and the singer from the Spin Doctors walks over to him and goes, "Listen, buddy, I don't know who the fuck you think you are, but you need to get your shit out of here because it's time for us to rock."
Oh wow. What a fucking dick.
Yeah, that happened.
Why do people do that?
I don't fucking know, bro. Like, be a dude. All right, now if I remember correctly. If I remember correctly, I gotta get asshole face over here. Turn around. Come here. Come on. Come get me. Come get me, bros. Get at me. Yep, there it is.
What? What are you doing? What are you doing? Dan!
Oh, shit. I don't know if I did it right. Oh, hopefully I did it right.
I don't know if I did it right. I don't know if I walked in the walls right. I think you did, Dan.
I might have went up too many times. Oh, fuck, I don't remember it. Gotta go over at the right time.
How the fuck do you even get out? Oh.
All right, so how it works basically?
What?
The game is all on one. Yeah, this is one of my favorite games. The game is all on one map.
Yeah.
So it's only the detection of the walls that prevents you from going to other parts of the game. So right now we're basically walking in the areas that we're not supposed to be in.
And you just got hurt.
Did I? Oh shit! Oh no! I did. I'm in the wrong place. I never went this way before. I don't know if I can find my way to the ending. We might be fucked.
The music changed.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. I'm not on the right screen.
There
we go. There we go. Now I'm right. And... hey, look at that.
What the fuck?
So we can start our new game plus.
Doopy!
New game plus coming up. So,
you heard it first. We beat the game.
Should we start by watching the ending?
Yeah, why not? Why not? I am the essence of the Triforce.
I fucking love this game. I love this game. But that's how much I love it, is that I know how to break it in 2 minutes.
The High Force will grant the wishes in the heart. Whoa, even the text moves differently in the ending.
To the past, baby.
The evil hearted person touches it.
So,
how the fuck did you do that? How the fuck did you just do that? Dan, what the fuck?
Yeah, okay, alright, I'll explain it. So, the game, the whole game is basically one map, and it's the parameters of the game are set up so that you can't cross these things. but if you break it, and I don't know why jumping off that, you saw when I jumped off that ledge and I saved while I was in midair.
Yeah.
For some reason, by doing that, it makes that part of the wall clippable, and then once you clip it, then you're fine. It's just about clipping through that wall, and then you can do whatever you want.
Really engaging story here. Something about Light World.
Hey.
But now you have destroyed Ganon.
There's a couple of cool glitches in this game. I mean, this one is obviously like kind of stupid because it's like, okay, you just skip the game and it's over. There's another one where you can get to the Dark World early.
Why would you want to do that? Get your ass fucked.
Yeah, I mean, if you're trying to like pro difficulty a little bit, you can go to Dark World real early in the game, and then you're like, yo, you're in those dungeons with like very few hearts, you know.
Far fudging out.
Mm.
Game over.
Yeah, baby.
Do we have to sit through the whole credits now?
Shit. We do. Or I can hit reset. It's been an interesting start to a stream, no?
Yeah.
Look at that I highlighted. That was great.
Whoa.
Oh, that was great. The maidens weren't highlighted.
Look at all
right, we should watch it, because look, this is crazy.
It's like glitching out a little bit.
Weird shit is happening.
You hear, like, the rain?
Yeah, right. It's still raining, because the beginning of the game is raining.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's great.
You're like, whatever. You just found a way to get the Triforce, so I guess that really helps us out.
So I'm like low key starting to work on a game. It's very low key. It's going to take me a long time, probably years. So let's not get excited.
Oh shit.
But it's honestly, it's been like a back burner hobby of mine since I was like 18. Like,
yeah.
Steve and I made a tech demo for a Chrono Trigger sequel. Like, it was like we had it released, and like people were like hounding us with emails going, "When are you going to finish?" And then we didn't finish cuz you know, I chose rock and roll.
Because life.
Yeah. I chose rock and roll and I fell in love with this girl.
Hey, your uncle recovers.
And then everything changed. You know what I mean? Like, my life changed. But yeah, at one point I've always been into... I guess we've had this conversation. I have what I would describe as a cinematic brain.
Yeah.
And I see video games as a cinematic medium. You know, like, you can...
That's why I love them.
It's interactive storytelling. And so, like, there's always been that want in me to tell a story in a video game, just like there's always been that wanting me to direct a film, which that's going to happen. And that's, you know, I've done short stuff, but like I want to do something that is linear, you know, like I want to commit to a linear film project.
I don't know why this is, like, again, this is why you call me the king of the non sequitur. But I just realized how I could help people, how I could put the idea in someone's head to make them stop drinking. Like, can I try it on you?
Sure.
It's just one movement. So this is how I would do it.
Oh God, mine's not bad right now.
No, it's not. It's not. I'm just saying.
I know,
like,
but dude, I already saw around here. Like, for those of you not following us on the camera because we don't have one, Sean just touched my turkey neck.
The male turkey neck, the gobble gobble that we all have.
Yeah, and he like underscraped it with his finger. And so, like, I felt it.
I just was thinking, like, the idea of doing that to someone. Yeah. Instead of, like, because, you know, there's, like, interventions. Mm-hmm. There's just, like, there's, like,
your neck fat.
Bro,
thing.
You need to stop drinking. there's, like, serious talks. And then that's just, like, a nonverbal, like, statement. And
it's like a heads up. Like, bro, your neck is getting out of hand.
Yeah.
Are you following the chat? We got any traction there?
No, it's just me. I wrote the word do, and we have one viewer.
Oh, nice.
So it's cool. I guess we'll have to stick around playing this game.
Yeah.
Turns out there's a bunch of people playing this game right now, so.
Sick. Well, I don't think anyone got to the ending quite as fast as we did, so.
Yeah, they don't appreciate it.
So we're playing the whole game on New Game Plus. It would be awesome if there was an unlock.
Yeah, I know.
If something changed, that would be
I fucking hate the forest thief. You can't kill him.
You can't kill him. He's a fucking...
Yo,
have you ever tried a spring powder on him? I don't think I've ever tried that.
Maybe. I don't know. I don't think anything happens.
You could spray powder on,
the fishes?
No, there's an enemy that you could,
the things that electrocute you?
I think the thing that turns you to a bunny. I think you can spray powder on that.
Oh, wow.
I saw that recently, and I was like, what? I think I was watching the Beard Brothers play it. And I was like, get out of here. Get out of town. Which is what Alex would say.
This might be one of those, like... What if this is one of those endings where it has like the end and you have to? Dude, it's still raining.
Oh, that's so cool. That's cool. If I could get no text and that rain image, I'm gonna get a screen grab. I'm going to keep my finger on the button.
Whoa, it's changing colors.
Oh, Shigeru Miyamoto, I fucking love you.
That guy's pretty dope, man.
I would like to drink with him. I would very much like to drink with Shigeru Miyamoto.
Bartender.
Do you have
a racist Japanese impression?
You stepped on my line, bro. I just had Shigeru Miyamoto order Tecate.
Oh, shit.
I mean, that was great. All right.
We have two views now, soon to be one.
Give me one moment in time.
I'm going to write in the chat.
We're just getting started. I know we're watching the end credits, but we're just getting started. I was showing my love for this game by beating it in under a minute.
Yeah.
That's what was happening.
Okay.
No, this really is. I can't say it's my favorite game of all time because Chrono Trigger exists.
Oh wow.
Yeah, no, Chrono Trigger is my favorite game of all time. But this is like this is battling for number two with Tecmo Super Bowl. Yo, Tecmo Super Bowl, greatest football game ever. I don't buy Madden because I just get the upgraded Tecmo roster every year. I just get the updated roster and go to town and play another Tecmo season because it's that damn good. Like when we go on the road this summer. Which, by the way, our bands, Roy G. Biv and August on Sunday, are going on a tour this summer. So if you are listening to this and you're not in New York, catch us if you can. Right? Yeah.
Like that movie.
When we go on the road.
Yeah.
We're starting a fucking Tecmo season.
Sure. I got to get good at that game, man.
I'm picking a team. You're picking a team. Anybody who's down to clown picks a team. If we can get Mike to pick a team, that'd be like the happiest thing ever.
Yeah, maybe.
It's two buttons, man. It's two buttons. Anybody can learn it. We got to get him in the spirit of it. It's not about sports. It's about...
It's an 80s video game.
It's an 80s video game. That's what it's about. I would like it if all six members had a team and we played through a season. That would be so ill.
Rob D and I are going to probably fight for the Giants. One of us is going to have to give it up.
Yo, draw straws, bro.
Yeah.
You should take the Bengals.
Boomer Sizen Bengals?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, bro. Take the Bengals because they're orange.
I guess so.
Give them the Giants. Or take the take the Raiders. Well, if we take the Raiders, you're gonna win. Whoever takes
Mike the Raiders then.
If we're using old school Tecmo, like if we're using the original Tecmo Super Bowl, then the Raiders.
Is that with Bo Jackson?
Yeah, he's insane. It's so cool. It's so cool.
You just do the run up and down.
You just eat face.
Yeah. That's fucking crazy.
Which I don't know if everybody. You have to watch the channel to know that Tecmo is our default game when we're not enjoying a game. We just switch over to Tecmo and play a game. Oh, no death run! Yo, no death run accomplished. Look at my no death run.
Nice.
Look at it. Actually, I am going to do an actual no death run. We talked it over before we started, and we decided this is going to be the casual playthrough where we just have fun and kind of...
This is the one where I could say when I finish it that I beat Legend of Zelda straight through.
Right, because I had a heart attack when this man said he doesn't think he's ever beat it straight through. And
yeah,
I'm just
being honest. I always like put the game down around like... Level 6 or 7 or something. Or no, Ice Palace. Right after Ice Palace, I'm like, ugh.
So we got a 1 there on Ganon's Tower.
Total games played.
So that's... Okay, so that's what a no-death run looks like then. Because, you know what I'm saying? Like, why did we get a 1 there? Obviously, we didn't do anything.
That's really interesting.
That's interesting. Yeah, that is very interesting. Boom, blap.
The end written out. In...
Same exact the end from the end of Super Mario World.
Wow.
Interesting. Can you go forward or do I have to hit reset?
I think so.
All right.
That's all good.
Boom. So we beat it once. Back in we go. Yeah, so Sean said he'd never beat it straight through, so that kind of turned this into the past the controller run.
Yeah.
So we'll have fun and we'll talk and I won't feel that pressure of not dying because when I do the no death run, I'm like... First of all, I'm very confident I can do it because Steve and I had a casual playthrough at his house just for the shit of it. Like we beat it in a night, you know, just hanging out talking. We were growing down, and we beat it straight through, and we only died, like, twice.
Oh, shit.
Whoa. That's so cool. Oh, my God. I can't even believe this is what... We broke it. That's amazing.
And it's, like, it's not the Dark World theme. It's, like, the bunny theme.
Oh, my God. How far can you go as a bunny? you're not going to be able to, you need to get to a place where you can go back to the light world. I don't know if you
Whoa.
Can. This is so cool. Oh, this is, I want to play the whole game like this.
Holy shit. What do we do? What do
we broke it. I didn't know you could break it like this. I never started over after doing that glitch thing.
I can't read the sign.
Oh my God. You got to get back to light world.
All right. I'm going to end this. I'm going to save this file.
Yeah. Oh my God. That's so cool. Oh man, Doopy. I was excited to play as Doopy.
I'm gonna play it. You know, we can still do it.
Yeah? Alright, cool. No, that's not... That's... No. No, can it be Doopy? It has to be Doopy. Revenge of Doopy.
You'll do Doopy's cousin. Doopy.
Doopy! what's up, Doopy? Let's do it.
Alright, Legend of Zelda.
Doopy.
Run 2.
All right, now I'm going to twist that yard.
Yes.
Yo, I'm trying to bring back grass. If you out there and you're watching the stream, I really want to bring back grass.
Oh, man. I got to write down all of the slang words for deuce. I mean, deuce is like...
Doo-doo.
Doo-doo, yeah.
Imperial.
Piff. We used to say it in high school in text message, so our parents wouldn't see. We'll be like, you play some hockey?
Play some hockey? I love it. Yeah, I really like Imperial.
Cop that Imperial.
Cop that yeah. Imperial is a great sentence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yarbo.
Yarbo of Initiative. Of course.
The Yarbo Initiative. Activated.
Yeah. There's a Zangleef. I came up with that one.
Zangleef, right?
Yeah.
Also Zangleef. Zangleef. Also Zangleef is acceptable.
Yeah.
If you like puns.
Let me see.
Ooh, it's lagging a little bit.
Yeah, I was going to say, it feels a little more laggy now.
What happened?
Is it because you broke the game?
Is it because I broke the game? Hold up. Well, sometimes you get momentarily, like baby lag for a second. Like, just my computer lagging out. Nah, we should be fine. Hold on. I could blarg it, but then blarg is ugly. Nah, I don't want to do that. Hold up. Sorry. I'm going to get out of full screen just for a quick second. Sean, don't move for a second. Let's just let everything settle in on itself. Yeah, we getting some
Twitch professional.
We get some Twitch problems. Hold up.
Twitch professionalism.
26.
I don't have that hat anymore.
Yo, what the fuck?
Bam, 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 bam.
Better? No, still doing it. What the fuck is going on, bros?
You broke the game.
I broke it.
You broke it for real.
I broke it for real. Yo.
All right, Zelda. I hear you.
All right. Controversial maneuver. Everybody hang tight.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm going to delete some of these files.
Yeah, we're just going to delete it. Delete the files and start over. That's fine. Maybe I did break it. I'm going to try not to kill the Twitch stream, though. I'm going to try to keep that going. All right.
Yeah, I mean, you got to do what you got to do.
If I got to kill it, we'll be back, but hopefully not. See, that's what this is what I was saying earlier when I was saying that my computer is getting long in the tooth. It's just behaving how it wants half the time. All right, go ahead, Sean. Delete the file. Start over.
There you go. That's looking good. It's funny how you can't skip that, but you can just skip it like right here.
But you can when you do the soft reset. It's really annoying. All right, everybody die. Get out. Sorry, Doopy and Doopy's cousin, Doopy. But Doopy the third is going to come strong right now. Oh, can you make it Doopy, like I, and then the number 3? So, like, Doopy the third? Doopy. There he is. Living.
Third time's a charm, man.
Living his life. Doopy's living his life.
All right, Link to the Past.
LTTP.
We like this game. Put it on a t-shirt.
Boom, blap. I'm gonna go on record right now and say that.
Yo,
you know how much I like this game?
Give him commentary, Dan. Tell him about it.
Sean, hold on. MC Greenspan is going. He got up from the microphone. He's no longer at his station. He's now going into his book bag, and he's pulling his dick out. No, he's taking off his pants. I never noticed his ass was quite this shapely.
Thanks,
you got like a hidden good guy butt. You know, I accentuate that shit because I'm proud. You know what I'm saying?
I've heard many years that I don't have nice butt, so that's actually
surprising. I don't know. Maybe it was just the angle, but it was shapely right there. I saw it. Oh, he is in the world class, world famous. Ah! Sean Greedy is in the basketball shorts. The universe is rotating as it should. Wow, I'm drinking and you're in basketball shorts? Holy shit, guy.
Throwback. Gotta let my nuts breathe, man.
Let him breathe, baby. Let him breathe. Oh, no. All right.
Yo, it's crazy.
This game is about to get fucked up.
We're big fans of the Game Grumps, and it's pretty crazy how, like, Dan Avidan, to his claim, he says he doesn't wear shorts, but he lives in, like, hot Southern California. I don't know how he does it, man. He's weird. You know, like,
in a lot of ways, Dan is like me and Steve mixed together.
Yeah. Which one of you guys would rock the New Balance?
I currently rock New Balance.
Nice.
He rocks arenas in New Balance,
literally. Tupperware Remix Party's dope, man. I'm waiting for them or Ninja Sex Party to tour New York. Because I would definitely go see them.
Yeah, I'll go see them.
Dude's from New York. Talks about the East Coast all the time. Only plays West Coast shows. Just saying. Well, love you all.
Yo, touring is expensive. Yeah. As we're finding out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, hey, I got a rupee.
I think if you, Sean Greeny, composed a proper email... You could help. You could get them to get us a show when we're out there.
Nice.
I think that you could make that happen.
I would play with them.
I would absolutely play.
I would love to.
I can't wait to tour with your band.
Yeah, man, it's gonna be exciting.
I think something special is gonna happen on that tour.
I think we're gonna become a very...
I think it's already starting to happen. When we got together last week, we had what I deemed I had a throwback experience. I went back in time to high school. My band, August on Sunday, and Sean's band, Reggie Biv. We went to a rehearsal space, the six of us, and just made noise for 3 hours.
Yeah.
It was great. We didn't play with, like, any songs.
Yeah, I was actually content. Like, it was one of those days I just, like, if I didn't play any music and I just watched the whole time, I would have been fine. And I would have paid for it. I would have paid to sat in that session and just, like, watch and listen. I eventually did jump in, and it was awesome.
Yeah, we jumped in. You were hilarious. You were the front man of that session.
Yeah.
My drummer played guitar for like an hour, and my bass player played drums for like an hour, and it was
fucking,
really cool.
Yeah, Neil was playing a lot of drums, too. He got pretty good at
it. Yeah, dude, Neil was killing it.
Yeah.
I didn't fuck with the drums too much because I didn't
play at all. I wanted to.
I realized something that actually at that session, that it was kind of a funny thing to realize. I'm a jazz drummer.
Oh, wow.
You know what I mean? And I was like, oh, I'm like moving this around too much. You know what I mean? Like it wasn't that day. It wasn't a day for like kissing bells and like adding in extra hits and but that's just the way I like to play drums, you know? Like I like that element of change it every time it comes around. But like, nah, we just needed like bedrock drums. We needed like four to the floor and I just didn't have it in me that day. Like I was like, I don't know, if you were playing a lot of guitar and I was on drums, we would have had fun.
Yeah.
But it didn't
we did bass and I did guitar.
I had a lot of fun with bass. When I was playing bass, I was having a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, my guitar, I was, you know what it was too? They had an orange amp, Rocker Rib 50, which is like, it's basically the amp of my dreams.
Oh yeah.
And so I've never played through one before. So I I got really emotional when I plugged my guitar in and I heard the tone. And what I really wanted was for everybody to leave the room so I could play that guitar out of that amp for like 4 hours by myself.
Yeah.
And then we could have a jam, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like I was already like in learner mode. It was such a weird feeling in my heart. Like I was like, I need to be alone with this amp is how I really felt. So I kind of like strayed away from guitar because I was like, you know, like I'm going to buy one. It was enough to tell me that I have to have that amp. I'm gonna buy a fucking orange Rocker Verb 50, and then I'm gonna give you my fucking Vox amp, and then life is gonna be sweet. Like we're both gonna be so happy.
We're gonna have really good guitar sounds.
Yeah, I bought Sean's amp by accident. Like, they fell in love. They're like, fucking my amp is cheating on me with Sean Greeny. It's like it's really painful.
It's a good amp, man. The last show, I have the bootleg on my phone. And in email form,
it's great.
But yeah, if you want a low quality, like I guess Steve recorded our set, but if you want like an audio bootleg of our set, I have it. Just gotta cut the snippets off. I'm trying to build bootleg collections.
I am that guy. I love bootlegs. Yeah. I collect bootlegs. I want all of your man's bootlegs.
I gotta start I'll start bootlegging your guys' show and just like, because I actually was inspired to do that from Dino because Dino would record his band sets well, and on his phone to like listen back and like make like, you know, adjustments.
Right, right. Well, this is the thing, Sean. Since day one of August on Sunday, and you can find old posts if you go back and read, we always encourage the open bootlegging of our shows.
Because, oh yeah,
I'm a bootleg collector and I'm a fan of bands that do that. So I always wanted that documented evidence.
That was and a big boomerang fail just there.
That's fine. And for years it bummed me out that people weren't doing it, but just recently I've acquired a technology where I'm going to be able to record the shows that we throw at the Leaf.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to bootleg every band that comes through and offer them, hey, you want the bootleg? You got yeah. it. Like, you know.
That's a good idea.
And I'm going back and forth between it's like, hey, give me $20 to cover overhead.
Yeah.
Or if I just kind of want to be like, here, you can have it for free. I gotta figure that out in my heart.
Thank you, Doopy.
So yeah, found Zelda.
This is one of my favorite news we've ever done already, by the way.
Yeah. Dude, Zelda. Zelda. I found her.
Get her.
This is our first time playing Zelda on the Arbo All-Stars.
I always thought she kind of looked like a nurse in this one. Yeah. You know, like she has like a nurse vibe. Shit, I rolled a fatty. I'm not sure if this is a great fatty, but I was half distracted while I was rolling, but I think we're going to be
out. I had like a momentary, like, just like a pain in my stomach for like a second, and it went away. And then I just imagine if I had like a heart attack live on stream.
Yo, that's crazy.
That'd be good for ratings, probably. It would help out Twitch if, like, it would be a news article and help us out. If I survived,
yo,
I put that money towards the band.
Yo, for real, shout outs to Twitch. Yeah. Thank you for existing. Thanks, Twitch. This is really cool.
Yeah. Twitch was like... Twitch is, like, great for me, especially because I'm an only child, so I don't mind listening and watching other people do things. Right?
I think that's part of why we became such good friends, is, like, we're both only children, you know? Well, and it's weird because I'm not anymore. I have, like, siblings that came into existence once I was already an adult.
Yeah.
You know? So that's a weird feeling. Like, I'm not an only child. My sister's 16 now, you know, and she's amazing.
Wow. She's going to be an adult very, very soon, man. Mm-hmm. You can have adult conversations with her. 16, I already felt grown up because that's when I had a house fire.
I was going to say, I already talked to her like on the level.
Yeah, I was going to say, once I hit 16, I felt like 15, I wasn't old enough to sit at the table. 16, I was. Mm-hmm. There was like a big difference.
That happened for me a little earlier than that, but same kind of thing. Yeah. You know, just like where you just like, all right, that childhood shit is not really happening anymore.
Yeah, 16, I was like kind of smoking cigarettes and like having some beers every now and then. And I was a late bloomer to that, but like I've since found out that some people don't drink till they're like in 20.
Dude,
like it's, there's no such thing as a late.
Steve and I started drinking together at 12. It was stupid, but that's, you know. But we grew up very like unsuper. No, go. I thought you were done. We grew up very unsupervised. You know what I'm saying? That's just how we lived.
And, put your lighters up.
And so we just got into all that shit early. But the cool side thing of that was, we got into that shit early, but then by 16, I was living a way more responsible life, you know? Like, I didn't fucking touch anything from, like, 16 to 19.
That's the way it should be, I think, in some areas. Like, how back in the day or in the South, you could get your driver's license when you're, like, 12. And it's like, think about it, dude. If you could, like, play a video game at 12, and you could follow a set of rules and know that there's punishments for fucking it up and, like, you know, physical or, you know, money... I think, you know, you could get people to do things earlier in life instead of, like, I get why people go to school and build a foundation, but, like, it all depends on your schooling, and if you get to learn about what you need to know in life, or, like, it's weird. I never grew up with a shop class, right. And I think that really fucked me up.
I never had
sex ed. Sex ed didn't matter much because I grew up with the internet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shop is another thing.
Sex ed was cool. I actually enjoyed sex ed class.
I would have lost my fucking mind if I heard about titties and vaginas and dicks and
watching the birthing video though was.
Oh, I had to watch that though.
That was intense.
Eh.
That shit was intense.
I had to watch that.
I'm glad I saw it.
Me too. It was actually yeah. That's the thing in school. It's like actually educational. You probably don't realize it at the time, or it seems stupid, or like you ever have to like dissect an animal?
No, but because I missed. All of those, like they happened, and every time I just wasn't in school.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I.
That was interesting.
Full disclosure, I skipped school a lot.
I didn't toward the end of high school.
Steve has a fucking hilarious story about me showing up in his lunchroom when they were in like the fifth grade. He's like, this motherfucker cut school and came to my school, and hung out with us.
That's really cool.
But like, I think about it now. I was doing that in a fifth grade. Like, I'm not necessarily that guy. Like, I'm not necessarily the guy. Like, I'm not a fucking guy that is, like, sketchy at all.
Got a red ruby already.
But
nice.
That was kind of sketchy for like a fifth grader to be new in. I just really didn't like. Okay, full disclosure. I don't really talk about this openly a lot at all. Full transparency on the program, right? That's what we say. I have really bad social anxiety. I don't like being in rooms full of people. I have what I've described as an empathy problem. I can really like feel people and their energies and their intentions and their feelings. Like if one person in the room is sad, I can't focus because all I can feel is how sad that person is.
Yeah, it's that I actually like I'll like don't forget what you're saying, but I was gonna say like I was thinking of the New York complex, or is like if I stopped and talk to every like old man and woman sitting down on the ground.
Yep.
I wouldn't have time to live my own life, and you have to like learn when to just keep walking.
And I would talk to them all because right.
I feel bad too, man. I know.
So like empathy for me is,
I've been so broke I couldn't. I had to stop giving homeless people money because I was like, now I'm just fucking.
Well, did I tell you about my last two homeless fucking people experiences?
No.
Oh my god. Okay. Quick aside. I'll get back to the anxiety thing.
Okay.
Because I think it's worth talking about. But, also, I'm trying to be more open. I've been hiding certain things in my life that I shouldn't be hiding anymore.
Yeah.
That's one of them. I have a very... I am an introvert with an extroverted job. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I play in a band, people think that I'm this, like, you know, glutton for attention and, like, that I love being adored and surrounded by people.
I think that's why it's good we do Twitch streams. Because like,
it couldn't be any more the opposite. I mostly just want people to leave me alone, you know?
I wouldn't say it's as extreme as, like, Twitching helps us exercise our demons, but it definitely helps me to, like... speak and like learn what works and what doesn't work and like how to like when something is said that you know you're gonna remember for like I'm the Butterbean of Twitch, something as simple as that,
so
like,
good. So
and, like
good.
You remember it forever, you know what I mean? Like
world-class moment for sure. So I was saying my last two homeless experiences, I was on my way, I hooked up with these cool people at Bridgeside Productions. They do a show called Bridgeside Live where
it's on YouTube. It's really awesome.
It's really cool where local bands get to come in and perform a show in a professionally recorded environment. It's really chill. My band played it, and I just hit it off with all the guys there, and guys and gals. Shout outs to Katie.
Oh, you're about to get the controller, bro.
It was a cool experience, so I kept going back, and now I'm kind of doing sound with them and shit. So I was walking there to do sound, and it was the first time I was going for that role. And so, you know, my head was kind of, like, pumped up. And I was like, all right, I'm going to get some fast food because it's quick. I can eat a burger and, like, you know, that's enough. So I go into Five Guys.
You said the magic word. Now I'm hungry.
I know. Cool. We might have to get some burgers.
It's cool.
So I go into Five Guys, right?
Yeah.
And there's a lady out front, and she's like, hey, can you get me fries? And I'm like, all right. You know, there was no question to me in that moment. I was like, yeah, sure, I got you. So I go inside. I order my food. I order an extra small fries, and I have them put it in a separate bag so I can give it to this lady. I walk outside, I give the lady the bag. She's holding the bag. We're both holding the bag in the transfer. She looks me in the eyes and goes, homeless lady. She goes, this is all you could get me?
Yeah, I've had that. I had something like that.
I was like, I grabbed the bag hard so she couldn't take it out of my hand. And I looked at her deep in her fucking eyes with that look in my, you know that look. And I'm like, what's your name? And she like, you know, tries to deflect. I'm like, what's your name? And I'm holding the bag. She tells me her name. I said, I'm Daniil. It's nice to meet you. Enjoy your food. And I let go of the bag.
Nice.
And I walked away. Heated. It stayed with me the whole night.
I mean, you handled it very well, though, so.
Yeah, well, she put her eyes down in shame, so.
Oh, here you go, man. You wanna?
Yeah, she learned a little lesson that day. But then, fast forward to a couple of days ago, I'm with Rob D, bass player extraordinaire, August on Sunday. And he's going up to get a Metro card, and there's a homeless black dude sitting there, and he's like, yo, brother, you could get me some Popeyes, and I look at him and I go, I say, oh yeah, man, I don't know where we're gonna eat yet, but wherever we go, I'll grab you something. He goes, no, I want Popeyes.
Jeez, man.
I'm just like, bro, this is not a good. We're not getting it right now. We're not getting it right because homeless people are in the street, being entitled.
Yeah.
And if you're entitled and you're homeless, things are out of whack.
Yeah. I've had situations like that. Some guy was asking, I was with someone and he asked my friend and I to buy beer for him. My friend bought him a beer and I just bought him a big thing of water. So he takes the beer and then he just looks at me, giving him the water, and he's just like, I don't want this. I'm just like, you can have it. I was like, you can have it.
You know what I'm saying?
I bought him like this big thing of water. Yeah. I was like, you can have it. Just
drink water.
Yeah.
You fuck.
Yeah.
Drink water, you homeless motherfucker. You know. So yeah. So like,
I've had that too, where I gave someone a dollar, and he's just like, "Can you just give me the other dollar in your hand?" He said that to me, and I was just like, "Nah, man, I need it." Like, sorry.
Yeah.
Like, shit.
I've always liked this part of the game because you get to just collect. Like this is like a real early like.
Also, the music goes lower when you go in the house.
Yeah.
Nice touch. Nice touch, designers.
I come here last though because I gotta get bombs.
Oh yeah, can we do like a quick story recap?
Oh hey, someone's in the chat.
One of the Steves in the world, Hump 2016.
What up, hun?
Steve says I call those homeless people Bernie Sanders supporters. Yeah, I think.
Damn, shots fired.
Yeah.
Oh man. Yeah, we'll make fun of politics because that shit where people say, "Oh, never talk religion and politics." Yeah, if you're a pussy.
This is. As someone who's never really been too much in the politics his whole life, this is probably the wackiest I've ever seen politics. Ever.
It's so crazy.
Ever. It's like, it's...
It's so crazy. So when it started out statistically, when it started out, all the candidates were speaking on a college level of language.
Yeah.
And Donald Trump was speaking on a sixth grade level.
Uh-huh.
He is now speaking on a fourth grade level, and everyone else is speaking on an eighth grade level. They are literally dumbing down to compete with Trump. That's you can go look that up. That's fucking ridiculous.
I keep looking at the Vegas odds for a presidency because those are the only people I trust with anything.
Right, you take money.
So, you know, originally I remember the odds were that Hillary was going to win, which would make sense. As of March 24th, Hillary Clinton, Donald Trump, Sanders. Sanders has like a mountain to climb in.
Well, if you take the road of like talking about like conspiracy theory type shit, and like if you start making it like, you know, cloaked backroom figures making decisions, this whole shit is about getting Hillary in the office.
Yeah,
because she's the passive option. She's the option that will be status quo.
It almost seems like it's going to be between Hillary and Trump, if I had to guess.
Which is insane.
The guy with the most money versus potentially the first female president. It's pretty crazy. Obama's almost over. I remember the day he got elected, and like, I was dating a super, super hardcore Republican at the time, so she was like crying all day and upset because she didn't want Obama to win. It was really funny. And I was just like the guy, I'm not into politics, I smoke weed musician boyfriend. So I was like, oh, that sucks, baby. I gotta go to school. Like, that's when I was still in college. I went to this college, St. Francis, which is really good school. I kind of caught myself. It's an okay school. It's aight. There's a lot of black people went there. So when Obama got elected, there was like, it was like celebration in the air. I never really, it was like kind of interesting. It wasn't bad. It wasn't good. I was like, I remember some people, do you remember like at the time some people were like, there might be a riot if Obama wins?
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't think it's going to be that bad. I mean, I remember when Italy won the World Cup in Bensonhurst in 2006 and like.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Cars going around. Like going fucking apeshit.
Everyone was so hype. It was like,
yeah. We should also point out we live in Dyker Bensonhurst area in Brooklyn, so it's a lot of it's a predominantly Italian neighborhood.
Used to be.
Yeah. It still is kind of changing.
Bensonhurst is different, but
yeah.
It used to be like, yeah, well, it used to be like it was an Italian neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? That part of it has changed a little bit, but it's still predominantly Italian. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right. Well, no, I can't even say that. It's really mixed here now, man. It's really mixed. It's mostly Asian in the last few years.
I live in a predominantly Asian part of Brooklyn. Like literally the block where it hits.
That is spreading to here now, where it's like it's getting more and more Asian. It's crazy.
I like this guy. He's like, yeah, I don't talk to my brother. I built this wall, so I can't talk to him. And then he's just like, yeah, oh yeah, fuck that guy. I guess, nah, maybe not. I guess nah, fuck that guy.
Yo, this dude was so pissed at his brother, he built a wall.
And you just don't even ask, you blow up his shit, and he's just like, ah, this guy's like, yo, man, I'm not even mad.
Yeah, he's a little brother, he's just chilling. Yeah. Those are cool characters, they should have been more involved.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. Give me my shit. Boom, blap, boom, blap, boom, blap.
I can't
blap.
Believe we never played the stream.
I know, this is kind of weird that we're just doing this now, but that's great. fuck your couch. Give me my shit.
Yo, I never knew you could jump over that.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah, I just went around.
Goddamn, bros. Come on.
I don't go that hard, man.
Get your pro status on, man.
Dang.
Chilling with a veteran.
You can do the dungeon if you want. If you want me to do the dungeon, you do. Unless you want to.
Actually, that's great. Yeah.
I know the first dungeon pretty well.
That's great. I wouldn't mind doing all the world map stuff, and you take the dungeons. Awesome.
Yeah. Well, we can switch. We don't have to, like, stick to us.
Yeah, I got you. I got you. Whatever feels good in the moment.
Yeah.
Because I literally know, like, we're not going to have to consult a walkthrough for not even one piece of heart. Like, I remember where
you should have me do, like, what, Ice Cavern? And then the two dungeons after that, because I don't have a lot of experience with those.
Nice.
So that's like where I would like learn it.
We got it. Yeah.
I beat Ganon for my friend. It was like I was like Final Fantasy VII.
Oh, I didn't actually talk to the kid who fucking is gonna tell. I'm ahead of myself.
I guess I did technically. Huh.
I wonder. Wait a minute. Can I go? Can I just go? I know where Hazalazalam is. Can I just go talk to him? Like, do I have to go and do all that first?
Yeah, I think you gotta talk to the grandmother and then talk to the kid in the bottom of Catherine.
Yeah, that's
Village.
What I'm saying. But like, well,
and then the kid's gonna be like,
I talked to the grandmother. I forgot to talk to the kid because I was just grabbing things. But what I'm saying is, can I just go to where he is and the game just is gonna be smart enough to tell me I'm good, or do I have to go and like talk to?
Take the walk, man. Take the walk. Explore the map. Get some rupees. Like, you can go back and double check. If the thought is there that it can fuck up. I mean, unless you want to gamble. If you gamble a man.
Let's go. I want to go see. Cause
get some heart pieces. Do your thing.
Yeah,
wait, we have four. Oh, wait, no, we already got four hearts from.
Yeah, we're one piece of heart away from another up. I don't know if there's one I can get.
Steve
right
is
now.
Saying that, yeah, Brooklyn has a lot of slopes. Like, I think he's talking, like skating-wise, slopes.
Right. Like the thing that's missing from the levels in Mario Maker.
Yeah, like, what are those? Horizontal, no, like diagonal roads. There's a lot of diagonal roads, is right. What Steve's saying.
And that's fair.
Yeah, absolutely. There are no slopes in Super Mario Maker.
That's true. That's also true. Not a one to be found.
You would think.
Oh, we're going to get a heart piece right now. Yes.
We getting that HP, motherfucker.
Get away
fuck
from me.
Fuck that fucking. Oh,
caught a bad one.
Caught that row, bro.
Get out of here.
I'm excited to do the Zelda games. I feel like we're going to end up doing most of these Zelda games.
Yeah. Full transparency, Zelda is my shit. Yeah. Except for Skyward Sword, because that game is booty.
I think we're going to have a lot of fun doing Ocarina, because I feel like I could control that game very well. There's something about when you run, like we're kind of running through this game right now in a way.
We got to get that capture card, bro.
Yeah.
We got to do it.
It'll happen. I'm gonna have money soon, I think, because I'm, you know.
Why'd I just do that? I'm an asshole. Yeah, oh, I love the music in this game.
Flippity bloopity.
Yeah, I'm playing Twilight Princess HD right now in my free time, and oh my god, it feels so good.
It's funny that you were playing Xenoblade Chronicles, and there's things called Skells, and you play with a band called the Skells.
Yeah. Yo, Xenoblade Chronicles. Actually, if you're like a RPG head, that game is great, man. I got 80 hours on that game, and I'm like barely doing the story. I haven't even got my mech yet.
Yeah, it's like me with Metal Gear Solid 5. I have like 80, 90 hours.
It's just fun. It's fun, man. It's a good one. What am I going to do right now? I'm going to go get bombs so I can get the ice rod.
Get bombs and then get bombed.
And we'll just do a little of that. Do a little collecting right now. A little collecting.
You're listening to Q104.
Oh, I got bombs. Hello. I'm an asshole. You don't have to do that.
Ba-ba-ba-ba. All
right. We're cool. I'll get the ice rod. I get a couple, two, three. Hey.
Yay, Steve, if you're there, Stevie. I have off the weekend of WrestleMania. I just have a show on Friday, so I can't make it for August on Sunday being on the show. But I could always watch it, because it'll be on YouTube.
Never heard of it.
Be on the YouTube / HiveMind Radio / just look up HiveMind Radio and Roy G. Biv or August on Sunday. Or the gallons of pork, fucking tons of chicken, buckets of chicken.
Buckets of chicken.
That's the gallons of pork tribute band.
That's another little pro tip that you can go down this here and get in here, like, you know.
That dude Vince's YouTube cover band is called 2U.
You're not supposed to be able to get here until you get the hook shot, unless you're smart enough to walk that wall. You know, more veteran pro tips. Oh no, I love this game. I fucking love this game. I love this game. I love this game, and then I love it more when you get the Pegasus boots. Oh, come on. What are we doing? What are we doing? Stop it. Why are we lagging? Why are we lagging? Come on. Come on now. I'll wait. I'll wait till you fix yourself. Come on, guy. Come on. Come on now. Alright, so I'll use this opportunity while my computer is being an asshole to go back to what I was talking about before, about social anxiety.
That, oh, wow, I just realized it was lagging. Sorry.
Yeah, that's the... No, I can't. I can't focus. Hold on.
Make sure you save at least. Yeah, I don't think we've saved once. Lag.
It's weird that it would just start lagging out of nowhere. It's like, come on, guy. Oh, boy. We've hit radio silence.
Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
All right, hold on. We'll entertain the people, Sean.
I like juggling. That's not true. I just made that up.
Have you ever juggled?
Yeah. When I was I was a camp counselor when I was like 15, and that summer I remember for like a couple of weeks trying to teach myself how to juggle, and I kind of had it with like juggling three balls
in your mouth.
Nah,
oh,
that's not what I meant.
No, I'm sorry, that was crass.
I took the low route.
That was
the
crass.
It's all good.
It was crass. I shouldn't have done it.
Shit, man.
Yo, we're totally gonna end up playing Lethal Weapon. Just for the record,
I can't believe they made that a Super Nintendo game.
It's so good, and by so good I mean it's pretty bad, but it's fun. If you can like, it's one of those games that's better.
Hey, we're back.
It's better with cheats because it makes up for like how bad the game is. Oh god. Oh, hey baby, now, hey now. Oh my god, no, I will not lose.
I need to shave my face.
No! Oh, God, sent across the belly.
Yo, you, what are you doing, man?
Bro, I jumped back in and things
This isn't even a no-death run. And
things got real. Yeah, I know. It's not a no-death run, but all of a sudden, I was like, I don't want
to
die.
Use that boomerang to, like, stun those hoes, man.
Get out of here. I'm scared now.
Oh, gosh.
Things have gotten scary. I'm scared. Oh, no, bee! Not the bees!
They ain't hooking you up with a heart, either.
Get out of here.
Neither.
I gotta dodge you. No, I gotta dodge you. It's my only way. Get ranked. Oof. Holy shit.
You sweating?
I'm sweating. A little bit sweating.
Things get real sometimes. Wrong part of the song.
No. Taste rang fury. Give me a heart. Come on, give me one heart. Oh, God! None of that. Nope, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. My spirits are not high. Oh my goodness. My reputation as a veteran. Get away. Get out of my face. Oh, God. Use the power of bombs.
Can't say bomb in an airplane. According to that one scene in Meet the Fockers.
Yeah, baby.
You might have to hit a save and quit, dude. No, I don't know. No. You're getting reckless. I mean, it's not a no-death run.
A no-death run. That's not what we're doing. It's not what's happening right now. I don't have to live that life.
Yo,
ooh,
yo,
get away.
Yo.
We're just collecting goodies right now. That's all we're doing. Give it.
A fairy. They spell fairy different in this game.
It's a fairy.
Fairy.
Fairy. I mess with fairies. Not as much as I mess with... Oh, you know what? You stupid. I'm not doing this pro status at all right now.
What are you talking
about? The mushroom. I should have got the mushroom already. I'm over...
Dude. All right. We're in pro status. We're just playing Zelda.
Nah, bro.
You beat the game by walking to the wall and you're like...
No, this isn't pro status.
Nah, I'm not feeling my behavior right now. But look, I'm going to make up for it right quick. I'm going to turn around. Gonna get that mush. You got to get that mush because the mush gets you the powder. And the powder is necessary. See? This is how you live your life.
You got to get some yarb powder.
Yeah, bro.
Yarb butter.
Something I ain't never smoked does before. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Myself included.
Yeah, me neither.
I never really touched stuff.
Zero dust. Never been dusted. Never been dusted. Don't think I ever will be dusted. I mean, like, maybe... My thing is, if I get past 65, I'm going to do every drug that I've never tried. So, like, if I get past 65, I'm going to try heroin.
Oh, shit. Put it out there.
Yeah, because here's the thing. Like, at that point, like, you know, if I haven't secured it all by 65, like, shame on me, right? Like, you would think, like, my family is going to be secure. My financials are going to be secure. I will have done the things I wanted to do in my life. And so all that's left is to experience. And so it's like, let me try these things that if something goes wrong and it takes me out, well, then it's no big deal, really. You know what I mean? I did my, if my gig is already played, I can die recklessly. You know? So that's how I'm looking at it. Because basically, that's really what life comes down to, just playing your fucking gig. So back to the social anxiety. Right? I wanna get that out. I keep not finishing that thought. Yeah, that's like very, very subliminal. Subliminally not finishing that thought because it means I don't have to talk about it.
No, it's just get off your chest. Chesticles.
Yeah, that's fine. We'll just play video games.
It's just like, it sucks having to be nervous about shit.
Whatever. Yeah, I
try not to think about stuff.
Crowds of people make me really fucking nervous. Because I can't remember why I was bringing that up in the first place. So who gives a shit? The time has passed.
I'm just really... I hate this dude.
Oh, you're such a dick.
Honestly, I always...
assumed he was a lesbian.
Wow, dude. That's controversial.
Not at all. It's
no,
just
you're controversial.
It's the haircut and the build.
You say controversial shit, dude. You know, you can't expect people to respond the way you want them to respond when you say controversial shit like that.
How's it controversial? I like controversy.
You can't speak the names of a thing that you're not.
Oh.
That offends people.
Oh.
You said lesbians. That's derogatory to lesbians.
It is.
Yeah.
I thought that was the... How is...
I don't know, but like that's...
I've offended... I'm sorry.
I mean, that just seems to be the way it is now, I guess. You know? You can't say things. You get in trouble if you say things. Anybody else tired of it? I'm pretty tired of it.
Congrats to the King Killer Radio folks. That's what Steve said in the chat. Yeah, we're doing like a fest. And it's like... over 2 days... 16 bands are playing, and we were originally slated to be the last band of the first night, which kind of would have been kind of lame. I mean, it would have been cool, but everyone would have been tired and out, probably.
Get out of here.
But then also, we got moved to second, so we actually go on early, and I kind of like that.
Nice. Now,
I wonder if I could get the Port Authority from... Nah, but I'm going to have all the gear. I'll probably be better if I come, like, maybe Saturday
So that's
morning.
Awesome. That's your show on Friday?
Yeah.
That's really cool, man. Oh, man.
That was the last show we played.
Besides Rockaway, that was the last venue we played, the Gateway. It was cool. I liked it there.
I wish I could be at that. That sounds like a really good time.
You got a gig too, man. We both got gigs that night.
No, we got gigs. Look at us. Yeah. I got gigs. Where am I going? What am I doing? Oh, did I talk to Little Boy? That's what I was doing.
I know. We're not doing First Dungeon.
Yeah, nice.
Oh, yeah, you did. Nice. Cool. Now we go to see Shara Shashala.
Shara Hasalam.
I say that right?
Shara Shashalam. Shahar Al-Azalam. That when we were kids, that's what we called him. Shahar Al-Azalam.
I think it's really like Shashrahala or something.
Yeah, Shash.
I'll try to pronounce it. Shashrahala.
They talk about it. That's what's really cool about Beard Brothers is the journalistic aspect. Like they do research. So they actually talked about like where that name comes from in like old mythology and stuff. But I don't remember. But
they play Link to the Past on Beard Bros?
Yeah, it's great.
Nice.
Yeah, they break all that shit down.
Do they hack the game like you?
They did the Dark World hack. They went to Dark World early.
Damn, son. These guys go hard.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, like, Game Grumps is more humor-based than gameplay based because they accept that, like, some games they just straight up are doo-doo.
Yeah.
Some games they're okay, like...
Well, right, the difference, like, for me, I mean, the premier difference I see between, like, a show like Beard Brothers and a show like Game Grumps, it's just Game Grumps are just, like, fully aware that they're rock stars at this point. They can't get around it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's cool, you should embrace it, make it part of the... Do some promos around it, you know what I mean? Custom promos.
Yeah. So, like, a lot of times, not that they feel disingenuous, it's just, it feels like performance. Whereas with the Beard Brothers, it has a little more of that two friends hanging out playing video games thing, which I like. And I guess, and also just in terms of, like, the shit that they say makes me laugh. Like the Beard Brothers, wow, I never thought about it this way. The Beard Brothers remind me of my friends. The Game Grumps remind me of, like, myself.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you know? The Beard Brothers make me laugh like the way my friends would make me laugh. And the Game Grumps is like, I find myself going, yeah, I thought that too.
Yeah. Steve said, oh, fuck, hold on. I pressed some button in the chat. Now my thing is loading.
And now your whole shit exploded.
Steve said, there's a lot of Christian Islam crusades parallels in this game. Game theory breaks that down pretty well.
Sick.
Oh, wait. I didn't see his name. Fuck. Oh. It is I. Shasha Basha.
Oh, no. He's like, yeah. There you go.
Sahasrala.
Can his name be Sriracha?
Sriracha. Doopy with a three. I'm Shalashaskar. Where's Mildred? I love, I guess, one thing Dan and I both share that character of, like, the clueless old man.
Oh, my God. Do you see what's going on right now?
I don't know where my pants are. Like,
do you see this?
What?
I got the mushroom. Ready to get the powder.
Oh, damn. It's all good. All
right. Sorry, man. I'm not equipping you properly for this dungeon.
Why would I? It's cool. Why would I need the powder in the first dungeon, Dan?
I'm just saying, like.
I could just use the mushroom and hold it up. Jeez, man, you couldn't hack the game and get me the Book of Medora too.
Yo,
yeah, you couldn't get me the Pegasus boots before the first dungeon. This is in pro.
MLG pro status.
How much can one hack a game, man?
Yo, I love this game. I want to make, like, in my ideal mind, I would just make this. I would like to make a game like this that plays just like this.
Susie Bitch Tits is what Steve suggested we call Sriracha.
Susie Bitch Tits.
Berkey, Berk, Berk.
Sarashasha Hasalasalam. I am going the wrong fucking way. That's why I'm coming from this side. Get out of here. Oh, I can't lift that. Ugh. Yo, this is, like, pointless right here. This never leads to anything.
This game is so...
Like, you can lift this eventually, but you don't get no great reward for going over there. There should have been a piece of heart there.
The tops of the trees look like nipples.
You look like nipples.
It's not true.
Your face looks like nipples.
My nipples look like nipples.
Get out of here.
I wish Tom Green was as mainstream as he was in the late 90s. That dude was really funny.
Tom Green? He seems like he's living a good life, though.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like he could have hosted, like, the Jimmy Fallon show, but I feel like the fact that he has the freedom to do whatever he wants suits him more. Like, that's a tough gig to pick up.
Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah. And you gotta admire the fact that he's, like, him and the Roots. Like, the Roots kind of accept that they're a house band, but they're also, like, they could also be functioning musicians on the side.
They're the house band for fucking Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah, and, like, that's, like, a really good gig, you know what I mean?
That's an example of, like, man, we're living in good, that, like, we talk a lot about the things in our day and age that aren't cool, right?
Yeah.
But, like, man, you're living in good times.
Yeah.
The world is way more progressive than it used to be. The Roots is the house band on the fucking Tonight Show.
Yeah. Yeah, and Jimmy Fallon is the host.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. He does really good impressions of Neil Young singing, and Bob Dylan singing Hotline Bling.
Should we actually tag?
Yeah, sure. Maybe tagged. Alright, I'm gonna check the chat real quick. 360 link scope. Linko scope.
Pro status, bro. MLG. I'm getting a beer. You want anything?
If you wanna get my water glass up.
Yeah,
got some water. Alright, I'm gonna start this dungeon. So just map it out in your head, I guess.
He's also using the bathroom. It's going to be a progressive Zelda playthrough.
We already have 676 rupees, dude. We're almost maxed out.
Nice. More money, more problems.
Yeah, what a... It's a good investment, though. Look, a little pricey. You gotta think about... The king offered only 100 rupees to find the descendants of the wise men. That's, like, not a lot. The king's stingy. Or you could pay 5 times that price and get flippers. It's weird that normally I go to the left, but... I'm pretty sure the map is in the right room, if I'm not mistaken. I actually don't even think I need to go this way. I'll do it for the pro status. Danny almost died before. Dude, I'm actually kind of tired right now. I'm not gonna lie. I might need like some food or coffee soon. This game was cool. I played this game a lot as a kid. I played the beginning of this game a lot as a kid. I think I was a little young for it, but I still kind of took it head on. Because when you're a kid, video games are fun, so you'll play whatever. And I had this in, like, Mortal Kombat for Super Nintendo. This is actually one of, yeah. This is probably, like, one of the first 5 games I've ever owned. Shout out to my dad. I guess someone told him that Zelda was a good game or something. No, no, no.
Oops.
Whoops the daisy. Yo, I think I want to wake up really early tomorrow.
That would require me to go to bed early tonight, though. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do.
Thank you, sir. Take a sip of my water real quick.
It's a very laid-back stream.
I know, it feels good.
So,
what is, Steve asked, what is Link and Sahasrara's default sex position?
Okay. Well, Link is like a doggy style. Stand-up Dougie style. So he's up on his toes, and he's doing the as he thrusts.
Oh, that's insane.
So that's Link. You got one for Shahazarazalam?
I don't know, man. It's tough. I would say... I think we used the sitting on the toilet one already, right?
We did that one?
Pants down to his ankles on the toilet.
I think we did, yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's not right.
Maybe reverse cowgirl, or maybe he's one of those like me. Maybe he's one of those like watching a young couple do it while he jacks it.
Oh, word.
Yeah.
I can see that.
I don't know why, but I think my favorite.
And he wears a headband while it happens.
I think my favorite. Default sex position that I said was Shaquille O'Neal's. He does the like, he's in nothing but sneakers, socks and sneakers.
Oh my god!
And he does like the pile drive like insert dick in mouth move. He does like squats kind of. It's like a weird like.
That's beyond ridiculous.
Yeah, man. I just think the fact that he wears sneakers.
It's so ridiculous because
thing is the best part for me.
I can see it. It's so real to me in my mind.
Yeah.
It's funny.
Dude, I would not want to be the dude who has sex with an NBA player. Or Kevin Nash. Unless he had a small dick. That'd be
just kind of fitting.
If Diesel had like a really tiny winky. He's just like, oh, wow. Did you ever see the, and I was thinking this might have been talked about on Steve's show, the Kevin Nash mugshot when him and his son got in a fight? Him and his 18-year-old son, and you see the pictures of both of their mugshots, and this kid is like 18 going on 30 with a full fucking beard. And he's just like, of course his 6'5" son looks like this.
Mm-hmm.
Kevin's 18-year-old 6'5" son. Oh boy.
Right, like Kevin Nash has incredible genetics. You know what I mean? And he's passing that on.
I used to always do the take the hit, make the play move on this. No, I can't do it for the button, I guess. I could do this way too.
There it is.
Whoa. 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 Oh. Noise. Glad those things can't go up the staircase.
Right?
Oh, I could use a powder on them, I guess. No, now you mention it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I kind of fucked you over.
In a way, in a way.
I'm sorry, bro. I'm sorry. I'm not pro status right now. It's a casual playthrough.
What if, like, a song like August and Sunday in the Waves was, like, on Barney? Just like, all right, kids, it's time to dance. And it's just, like, B-heavy blues, like, drone song for 8 minutes.
I missed that
and
song.
Like, a boo-boo-doo-boo-doo-doo, like, you know?
What's cool is I wrote a new song in that tuning.
Oh, I almost forgot to get the weapon.
So now there's going to be a reason to have a guitar in that tuning, which means we'll be playing that song live again.
Sometimes we do, like... Like, on shows where we wouldn't do Oh No, we play the Oh No riff, or we, like, hint at our old songs, or we'll do, like, a riff of one of our new songs, and then be like, the psych, we're playing this song move.
I was playing that song yesterday, Oh No.
Nice.
On my guitar, because I think that's the one that we're going to cover for the EP.
Nice, man. Yeah, Brian fucking, that's Brian's, caramba. That's Brian's riff, translated by me.
Because, yeah, we're doing this cool thing before the tour. Sorry, guys. I'm chomping down sushi.
Yeah.
Really?
You might have to order me some, man. I might get sushi two... What is it? Not 2 days in a row, but two times I've been here.
I really wanted a burger, but I saw this in the fridge, and I was like, you know what?
Yeah.
I'll eat this. Yeah, well, I was going to say... Oh, yeah. So I'm going through this thing where my pops is going through, like, a later...
I have too much money at this point, dude.
Like, a later in life... all of a sudden, he fell in love with sushi, and it's like... Yeah, motherfucker, I've been waiting for this my whole life. So now, like...
Sometimes, you gotta be like, yo, stop fucking up my whole life.
Like, yeah, that's real. That's real. Yeah, because when I was growing up, I loved sushi. And, like, my dad's a very picky eater. And so he wouldn't want to, like, fuck with that, you know? So if I was gonna eat sushi, I had to go out to eat with friends or something. Never could just order it to the house. But, like, now it's, like, the other way. I'm walking in and there's fucking sushi in the fridge. I'm like, get out of here! Gimme.
Yeah, you kind of got me rehooked again, too.
Although
I've never been... I mean, there was just one point in my life where I was like, oh, sushi's dope, but I just never get it, because I don't really know, like, the rolls to order. I just know what eating food tastes like.
Right.
Oh, can you give an update to the Yarbo Initiative crowd about we listened to Angel of Death right after the stream last time.
Oh, my God.
That's going to be the heel Sean Greeny theme.
So brilliant. So brilliant. One of the finest.
Yeah.
I mean, like... Like, you know, like, life...
It must have been, like, when, like, Triple H heard the fucking Motorhead song, and he's just like, this is it. This is me. This is my theme for forever now.
It's just that thing of taste, like, the choice to start a song with that.
Oh, yeah. That's why it has to be Heel Sean.
It's incredible.
Yeah. Mm. Like, Good Sean is not going to rock that shit.
But, yeah, so I was saying, our bands, we're going on tour in the summer together. And we're doing a split EP, which is really cool for me because, you know, when I was growing up, that happened with bands that I liked, and I always thought that was really cool. So we're doing a split EP, and the way we're doing it is each band is putting an original song on it, and then...
Shit, I just finally had... Yeah, keep going.
And each band is putting a version of... What we're going to do is... Each band's going to put an original song. We're going to do one song together, both bands. And then we're going to each cover the other band. So,
yeah.
So, I think we're going to do the Roy G. Biv song called Oh No. You got to wait, bro.
You're not pro status right now.
Come on, bro.
I got to go right here.
If you waste them arrows. You got it. I'm fine.
Free falling.
Yep, that is. Send them on their way. Send them on their way. Send him back to hell. Yeah, Sean. Mm. So yeah, I think we're gonna do Oh No, and I was working on the riff last night, and I was like, I was like, man, this is a great song.
Hey, if you need the chorus for any of the parts, I can tell you, but it's pretty simple.
I think I got it.
G, C, D, A. I only do a major chord at the very end, like right before the Oh No! Like right before that is I do like full major bar chords. Oh, I didn't catch it midair, by the way. I wasn't paying attention. It's broken. Probably cracked it now. Do the first dungeon in Link to the Past, bro.
What are your thoughts?
I'm really sleepy. And I think it's because this game is very soothing, and also because I'm sleepy. I think I might have to order some food or something. We could keep streaming if you want.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna have to maybe get a coffee at some point, or like that was my morning coffee, to be honest with you. I kind of like I rolled out of bed. I showered last night. Oh, you want to take over?
Sure.
I changed the cat litter and I just got on the bus.
I gotta do that too.
I did it right before I left my house. It was funny because my mom G'd me. I got old school psyched. I got psyched. Uh-oh. Return of the Schmag.
Yo, what is up with this just random lag shit? What is going on?
I decide when you get the lag.
All right. I'm not even going to wait around. All right, tell your story. You got G'd by your mom's.
Oh, yes. I thought she was coming home today, so I was like, I got to freshen up that cat litter because, like, you could let it sit like a couple of days, but if she comes home and it's just like straight up doo doo smell,
yeah,
it just doesn't look good. Yeah. I'll be like, at least hit him up with the freshie before she comes home, and then she's like, oh, I'm gonna be home on Sunday.
Nice.
And I'm like, oh well, at least I did it.
Nice. Oh my god, remember that? Remember when your life was motivated by like,
oh shit, I didn't read Steve's default exposition. Link holds his cock like the Master Sword when it charges, and it then spins around as he's coming.
Wow.
And Shower Jazzy jerked off on all those psychic tiles, by the way.
Wow.
Yeah, put your hand on the psychic tile. That's my jizz.
Sacrificial jizzo, bro. That's a... sacrificial jizzo. I feel like that's... Sukkoden?
Insane Clown Posse song. Magic everywhere in this bitch.
Magnets. How the fuck they work?
It's not even low key. I actually love that song.
That's a great song.
That's my favorite Insane Clown Posse. That's a song that made me be like, all right, you guys aren't as dick as I thought you were. Like,
yeah, people are gonna make fun of it and shit on it, but it's like, come on, that's great. They would have the like, you gotta
in
not
the in the video and like,
you're not taking yourself too seriously if you release that song.
Yo, out of all the like, in a weird way, like I could never relate to like Insane Clown Posse lyrics. And then there's that one part in that song when he's just like, a seagull almost took my phone away when I was on the beach. And I was like, yeah, like, it's not exactly, like, 100% relatable, but that's like, wow, like, that's different. They're pulling a fucking, they're pulling a U2, they're pulling a Radiohead, they're changing their formula. They, like, actually, like, taking risks, you know what I mean? And again, they got made fun of for it at first, but then, like, it kind of put them in the spotlight again. And that song has like 5 million hits on YouTube. Like, in the end, they made some money from it too.
Yeah, that's a hit, right?
Yeah, like,
fuck you, man. They got a hit. Yo, fuck you. Insane Clown Posse is still a thing.
Oh, by the way,
how many people just trying to get their thing off the ground? Like,
I have a good picture, Steve. I'll send it to you. It's a still cap from when I was filming a lot of YouTube videos a couple of years ago, and it's a freeze frame of. Hold on. It's a freeze frame of Ricky Vega with long hair and Hawaiian shirt and Rob D's dad just watching him.
Sick.
Yeah, I'm going to show it to you. I'll send it to you, Steve.
Yeah. Oh, man, Ricky.
It's a good moment. It's a good moment in time I have captured on film.
It's weird that I just felt in my heart that I'm like, I missed that. I missed that guy.
What a card, though, Ricky Rock. He's still a young gun, man.
Yeah, I miss Hawaiian. I miss Taino Indian Ricky, man. That was a good time.
Ricky's great. He has a really good voice.
Such a great guitar player. Such a great guitar player.
Yeah. Oh, he's insane. God. I told him I geeked out over one of his parts in one of his songs. Like, you were playing something like this, and I sang it to him, and I'm making these finger movements, and it's just like, I don't know what song that is, man, but, like, shit, that's awesome. I do that a lot to bands where I'll be like, I like this part of the song, I did that with the Scales, and they're like, oh, this song. Yeah, man. Thanks, dude. Like,
I really like Orson Welles.
Yeah, man. They fucking have a lot. Brian is a really good drummer, and he's added a lot to that band.
Yeah, I really, really like them a lot. I'm like, man, your music is great.
Yeah.
And I jammed with them, and it was a lot of fun.
Tom's like, he's another one of those like actual low-key natural songwriters.
Yeah,
he could just be in a room with an acoustic guitar and then just like sing like a fucking 64 line ballad or like a long ass fucking song. He did that once. Like, I think when you learn to like just learn songs, even if they're not your songs, just so you can know them, and you could bust them out whenever and like relay the message. It's just like, that's what I would suggest to musicians who want to like start a band. Is like, don't be like, oh, this is not my song, I can't learn it, I can't sing it. It's like, why?
That's it's funny that you say that, because that's like, every musician has a category where they get a four. That's the category where I get a four. I cannot remember, for some reason my brain doesn't retain other people's shit, and I never been the kind of guy who could like.
Yes, but I mean I've heard you like kill covers of like Nine Inch Nails or like Van Morrison. Or, like, you'll know, like, songs like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But, like, most covers don't stick in my mind. Like, I'll learn.
Same here.
Learn a cover. I'll have it for a little while. And then, like, some people are, like, Dave Johnson, incredible interpreter. He can just pick up a guitar and play you any one of, like, 1,000 songs.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's great. And I'm like, man, and I love listening to him do it. But I'm not that guy. And I've never been that guy. And it's funny because in that way.
Learn some Led Zeppelin songs, man.
In that way, I always say, like, I'm not really that much of an entertainer. Oh, shit. You know what I didn't do? I know exactly what I didn't do.
Hack the game again?
No. I didn't go back because the lag, so I saved and quit. I didn't go back to Shara Hazalazalam for my fucking boots. Give me my boots.
Mildeuce.
I want to run, bro.
It's like mildew, but deuce.
Yeah, that's an area where I get a four. Like, I'm not a crowd pleaser like that. I can't just whip out, like even like Rob D could just break out American Girl and like please a whole room full of people. Like,
yeah,
I can't fuck with that. That's not me.
You gotta find a song that you like and other people like. Yeah, it's there.
I know. I guess. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that magical combination hasn't come out. Where
just, you know, just pick up a guitar and just be like.
Boom boom clack, boom boom clack boom.
Straight Pixies apparently.
Boom boom clack, boom boom boom.
Is the Pixies? I wonder if Frank Black is like, hell yeah, we inspired Nirvana. Or if he's just like, damn, that's the Pixies song I didn't write. The song everybody didn't write.
Yeah.
And everyone could have.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's a good song, and it like it's very. Very much follows the formula down to the T, where the melody of the solo is the melody of the song.
Oh, we got the boots.
I like songs that do that.
We got the boots now. Get at me, dogs.
Oh, man. I think we might have to take a food break soon.
Whenever you're ready, man. I kind of refueled on air like a jerk. But.
No, that's cool. We could, might take a food break. We'll probably come back. If you guys want us to keep playing this, let us know. If you want us to go back to No Mercy, let us know. If you want us to play something else, let us know. Let it snow.
He's pretending like you have choice. We're playing this.
We still have to make Steve. And
we do.
No Mercy.
We do. But now.
One of us has to. We're going to have the 2-on-1. Steve's going to have to side with one of us. Or it could be a triple threat.
Oh, shit. Or we can make him special referee.
Oh.
Clap. Give me the Book of Madura. I got the Book of Madura.
The best weapon in the game.
I got the Book of Madura.
The best weapon in Zelda history. That Book of Madura is why. This is the greatest Zelda game of all time.
Agreed. I wish they would bring it back. When's the last time you saw the Book of Madura?
They just don't care. It's like Geno from Super Mario RPG. The coolest character that Nintendo doesn't give a fuck
about. I like how you're just always advocating for Geno.
Yeah. He has Super Smash character written all over him. He has a fucking gun for an arm. He's made up of fucking stars. Like where he comes from the land of stars in a form of... In the game, he's like an action figure doll come to life. So this kid is playing with a character named Geno. And it's yeah, I don't want to spoil it for you, but he's dope.
So what you're saying is, get on your shit, Nintendo.
Yeah, like, we have a fucking Wii Balance Board as a fucking weapon or some shit. Or like, Amiibo.
Remember that?
To be fair, that was a really successful game, and I played Wii Fit, and it was a really interesting idea.
I enjoyed Wii Fit.
I enjoyed it a lot, actually.
I had it. I just recently threw away my Wii Balance Board.
Ah, I threw mine away too.
It was just taking up too much space, and I was like, I am literally never going to use this again.
Yeah.
There will not be a day where I'm like, I want to play a video game that's going to make me stand on a board. Never going to happen.
Magnets, how did they work? Oh, nice. Steve's cutting up shit from the new intro. Oh, hey, it's my voice. Peace out, my voice.
Yeah, I gotta do some work for SJE, actually.
I can't wait to watch WrestleMania.
Yeah, I know, me too. Well, the card looks terrible, but...
Yeah, I mean, like, I can't wait
for... I don't
think
it's gonna be a good WrestleMania.
I can't wait for the event of watching WrestleMania.
Yeah, exactly.
And fucking Dean Ambrose having the best match.
Yeah, it's gonna happen. Although,
are you excited? Did you say on air? You never said on... Did you say on air the Cena turn heel?
I didn't say it on air. Yeah, but no, that's coming. Cena heel turn. Steve would call these kinds of things all the time. Cena has not been talked about. It has not been mentioned.
I would say it would be equivalent of the Hollywood Hogan thing.
He's gonna heel out on Shane McMahon, and he's gonna align himself with Vince. It's gonna happen. John Cena heel turn, WrestleMania. Mark it down. Put it in a book. Boom, blat. Put it on a T-shirt.
I hope that happens. You watch WrestleMania and see which wrestlers are not used in the promos besides Chris Benoit.
Do you understand that it would have been Undertaker Sting?
Oh, shit. Yeah, Steve making ribs. I remember there was a lot of food last time.
Hell yeah, ribs. I messes with ribs.
Yarbo Initiative. I mean?
Yeah, bro.
Doodly diddly. All right,
so.
Smoke dupes.
Question.
Answer.
Yes.
Do you want to take that food break now before we do this dungeon or after this dungeon?
Yeah, I would say so.
All right, so here's how we're going to leave you.
Nice. Do like a save state or something? Yeah, boy. Now,
all right.
Now you pray like a motherfucker.
All right, we'll be back.
Yeah, we're going to get food. I'll text all the Steves out there in the world when we're back.
Peace, later, peace.
Later, guys.
Peace.